Triton Knoll is an offshore wind farm being developed by Energy Renewables UK Limited. It's located in the North Sea, roughly 33 kilometres off the Lincolnshire coast. The development consists of 90 turbines, with a combined generating capacity of 900 megawatts. That's enough to supply 800,000 UK households. Murphy have been appointed to construct the onshore cable connection from a landfall point at Anderby Creek. The other end of the connection is at the newly constructed substation at Bicker Fen. The route crosses land occupied by 123 landowners and tenants and interacts with up to 700 land plots. This is the longest cross-country cable connection ever constructed in the UK and is approximately 58 kilometres long. The construction of the onshore cable involves many different techniques. All of these work activities are carefully planned and sequenced. This is to meet the completion date in August 2020. Each task is planned effectively, taking account of any environmental conditions which could impact the way we carry out a task. Supervisors will explain the method of work and the risks involved to everyone carrying out the task. This will enable us to deliver the project safely, with minimum disruption, and whilst protecting the environment. The safety culture at Murphy is measured by the presence of positive actions, not the absence of accidents. Our six simple actions will guide the steps we take every day to protect ourselves and our colleagues. Our simple actions mean we always have safety documents in place, protect our health, control our work area, prevent service damage, operate plants safely, and protect the environment. Remember, the safety culture at Murphy isn't measured by a lack of accidents. It's measured by the presence of positive actions. We'll now go through each of the simple actions. The first simple action is we always have safety documents in place. There are several documents that are key in keeping you and those around you safe. Issuing permits controls our work activities where they are required. We use permits during tasks such as breaking ground, working in confined spaces, and working in close proximity to overhead lines. Site-specific risk assessments before starting works ensure that significant risks have been mitigated. Ensure that everyone is fully briefed. Make sure that all members of the working party are aware and signed on to any required safety documentation. When on site, if you see something that doesn't look right, stop the work. If someone asks to see your documentation, respond positively. We're just trying to keep each other safe. Make sure that anyone engaged in work is properly trained, competent, and authorised. And finally, when working with energised systems, make sure you're protected by lockout or isolation. Our health has a huge impact on our lives, both outside and inside of work. It's vital we take steps to protect it. Ensuring that you are fit and healthy before completing any work is very important. Make sure you attend medical assessments and comply with identified restrictions. Take all necessary steps to reduce your exposure to harmful levels of noise and dust. Use methods and tools to prevent injury when handling equipment and materials. Control and monitor your exposure to potentially harmful vibrations. Wear all required PPE and keep it in good condition. Ensure you're free from the effects of alcohol and drugs and are fit to work. Create and encourage a positive culture and take care of yours and your colleagues' mental health. Murphy is a member of Mates in Mind, an organisation that helps break the stigma around mental health. We also provide access to confidential counselling and support through our Employee Assistance Programme, a 24-hour service that gives you access to trained counsellors and advice on a range of work and home issues. When we're working on site, control of our work areas is a key way we can keep ourselves and our colleagues safe. We will always define and maintain safe distances from plant, equipment, and vehicle edges, ensuring that barriers, warnings, and all other safety protections remain in good condition. When working at height, ensure that it is properly planned with clearly defined work areas and control measures. Make sure that safe access and egress to our work areas is maintained at all times. When we're working, we must protect members of the public and other contractors from our works area. And finally, at all times, we must know who is in control of our work area. All of these things are key in keeping ourselves, the public, and other contractors safe. It's important that we control our work areas effectively. Further guidance on how to do this is available in the ShesQ Minimum Site Standards booklet. Breaking ground is potentially the most dangerous part of any works. Every time we work around services, we expose ourselves to risk. It's vital we always take steps to prevent service damage. Ensure that all identifiable services are traced and marked. Obtain service drawings from utility companies before breaking any ground. Use safe excavation techniques and always hand dig when operating within 500 millimeters of any known service. Follow the agreed methods to avoid danger from overhead power lines and make sure you erect appropriate signs and barriers. Following these simple actions will help keep everyone on site safe from potential service damage. Working in and around plants and vehicles is one of the biggest risks both in the industry and within Murphy. Identifying these risks and controlling them can make ourselves and our colleagues much safer. Firstly, only allow correctly trained and competent people to operate plant and vehicles. Before using any plant or vehicles on a Murphy site, check that it is safe to operate and legally compliant. When required by the Safe System of Work, or SSOW, use banksmen and vehicle marshals to control vehicle movements around site. Although it seems obvious, obey speed limits and always wear seatbelts where they're fitted. Speed limits are low for a reason. Ensure that any handheld mobile phones can't be a distraction when driving. Make sure that any safety protections, such as flashing beacons, load limiters, or alarms, are functioning correctly and are used when appropriate. The simple actions focus on keeping ourselves and others safe, and this responsibility extends to the environment as part of our never harm value. We must always strive to prevent environmental damage to water or land, prevent nuisance to neighbours from our emissions, and comply with relevant consents, permits, and licences. We will safeguard wildlife and protected sites. We will also segregate, store, and dispose of waste legally and responsibly. Following these simple actions, having safety documentation, protecting our health, controlling our work areas, preventing service damage, operating plant safely, and protecting the environment are simple steps we must all take every day. And remember, if you see something which you don't think is correct, question it before work begins. If in doubt, report it to a supervisor. Question before action. Work areas will contain first aiders, fire wardens, emergency stations, and welfare. Familiarize yourself with these people and locations before starting work. The nearest hospital will be pointed out on the emergency contact sheets displayed around the project. Take the time to read this information. Please make sure you sign in and out of your work area. In the case of an emergency, an alarm will sound and you must evacuate immediately to the nearest muster point where your supervisor will take a roll call. Working hours on the project will be briefed to you by your supervisor. Any deviation from these will require prior agreement from the project manager. Lone working may only be permitted by the project manager. Some roles on site require different colour hard hats. Supervisors on this project wear black hard hats. If your role requires a different colour hard hat, it will be pointed out to you by your supervisor. The minimum competency on this project is the CSCS. Please ensure this is passed to your induction host following this video, along with any other applicable competencies. Please ensure you adhere to the traffic management plan at all times whilst travelling to and from the site. It is a requirement to sit the Murphy driving induction on this project, which will detail the control measures in place to keep you and other road users safe. Loading and unloading vehicles is a key task on this project. Always aim to use mechanical means for loading and unloading, following our lifting procedure. If you're unsure, speak to your supervisor. Working on the back of vehicles is only allowed if adequate control measures are in place, such as edge protection, fall restraints, or airbags. All deliveries must be planned and controlled. We must not access land until we have permission to do so. Please do not enter any land unless your supervisor has confirmed it is okay to do so. Remember to close any gates and be aware of any public rights of way. We must ensure public rights of way are maintained at all times and pedestrians have right of way at the crossings. If you have any questions about the above, please ask your supervisor for more information. In the event of an incident, it's important that we react correctly and report issues immediately. Any observations, near misses, or incidents must be reported immediately to your supervisor or member of the management team. 212 is the online incident reporting system. It's available via SharePoint under the Tools menu. There are four key timescales within the reporting framework. First, you must immediately report any accident or incident to your project, site, or line manager. Within 2 hours of this, the manager logs the initial details of the accident online via the reporting form. Within 1 day, the manager must complete the initial incident report. And within 2 weeks, depending on the severity of the accident, the managing director and the ShareSQ lead will oversee a full and final investigation report. Due to the location of this project, there is a residual risk of encountering unexploded ordnance when breaking ground. Although this means the risk is low, there are a few things you and your team can do to ensure an effective response should anything be encountered. When setting to work, your supervisor will let you know if you're in a low or moderate risk area. Low risk areas require you to be vigilant and follow UXO procedures. Moderate risk areas will have been cleared by a specialist. You can see on this map where the low and moderate risk areas are along the route. If you spot anything unusual during excavation works, please follow the following protocol. Do not disturb or interfere with the item. Retreat from the suspect object and establish an exclusion zone of at least 20 meters. Inform the site management team, who will contact a UXO specialist. Await further advice from the UXO specialist before allowing anyone else into the exclusion zone. At certain points along the cable route, archaeological features have been identified. Specific mitigations have already been put in place to ensure that archaeological discoveries are handled appropriately. These include set piece excavations, strip map and recording, and targeted archaeological monitoring. If you're working in an area that might be affected by these, your supervisor will make you aware of them before work commences. Depending on the archaeological activity near your worksite, certain plant may be restricted, or an archaeologist may directly control the extent of work in the area. The cable route and the surrounding area support a diverse ecosystem, including animals that are protected species. We're aware of water voles, badgers, and great crested newts. It's important that we implement and monitor any control measures put in place to protect these species. You will be notified of any applicable controls in place. Thank you for listening to this induction. You will now be asked to complete a short questionnaire to confirm your understanding of the topics covered. Following the successful completion of this, you'll be set to work by your supervisor. Please remember, to raise any feedback on the project via the CDP cards and challenge unsafe behaviour. If you have any questions or concerns about the content of this induction, speak with your supervisor or a member of the project management team.